Let's talk about rescuing lost pictures. Pictures you've deleted accidentally, on purpose, just now or in the past. For example, have you ever found a memory card in the back of the drawer and wondered what was on it? But I'm not talking about what is on it. I'm talking about what was on it, because I'm telling you that even if you can't see pictures or video, they may still be there. Forgotten memories, lost friends, family members, you may be able to get some of them back for free. Hey, welcome back. And if it's your first time here, just welcome. I'm going to show you how you can recover lost or deleted pictures and video from a memory card. Pictures you can no longer see, pictures and video. Here I have a compact flash card, but this works with SD cards as well. And this one has been in a drawer for almost a decade. I deleted the pictures long ago, took more pictures and probably formatted the thing as well. But they many may still be there, waiting for discovery because of the way cameras add data to cards. Imagine a long, complicated book. Like this one. Imagine each page full of code is one image. Flicking through, it would be hard to find a single image to put your finger on. What you need is an index, a cataloging system, if you will. And that happens on your memory card. When a picture is taken, the data goes on one part of the card, the page, and then there's an entry made in the index to show the software where to find the picture. When you delete a picture, it's the index part that's removed, not the data. So the picture is still there. The problem comes when you keep taking pictures because the new data overwrites the old. But not always. And there's software to help you recover those pictures and video. And that's what I'm going to do today. There are a few things you're going to need. A memory card, obviously. A computer, because this software doesn't work on a phone or a tablet. And a means to connect the card to the computer. Some computers have a card slot, but you may need a card reader. And these are inexpensive. This one was less than $10. Let me just show you. If I grab my old camera that would have actually taken these shots anyway, put the memory card in. I'm just going to show you the back of the camera, and as you can see, there's nothing there, no photos at all. Sadly, this doesn't work by plugging the camera into the computer, as the software interface is different. And talking of software, I'm going to use a couple of different options, because I prefer either Photorec or Recuva. Now, I'm not paid by these companies. I have no affiliation with them other than using their software, but I'm going to test both to see which one finds the most images. But either may work better for your card, so it's worth trying both. So let's first look at Photorec. This is a DOS-based system, so it's a bit clunky to look at, and the file formats it can find are okay, but it's built on older software, so it may not recognize all of the new formats. JPEGs and RAW files are fine, but some of the video files might be a bit trickier. The advantage of Photorec though is that it recovers all sizes of files. Recuva can do it, but there's a size limit to the files it can recover in the free version. I'll leave the links to Recuva and Photorec in the description below. So when I put the card into the card reader, you can see I'll just open the file there. Nothing shows up. This is an empty memory card. Or is it? Let's fire up the software. The scroll down to the Q Photorec. As I said, it's a bit clunky. So you find the file that you want to recover. In this case, it's the D drive. There's various ways that cameras can store data. So we'll look at the whole card, not just in the D800 file. And then you want to select the folder that you want the recovered files to go into. So I'm going to just stick on the desktop, select a new folder, and I'll call that recovered. Select that folder, and then you can change your file formats. I just leave it on everything and press search. And it's going to take some time depending on the data on your drive. 16 gigabytes like this card will take a while. So I'll speed this up and I'll see you in a few seconds rather than the hour that it's going to take to do it. So as you can see, it's found 855 files. 821 were JPEGs, 23 were TIFFs, although there were no TIFFs on there, And then there's a few other files, which are probably either unknown formats, parts of an image, or files from system files, things like that. So I'll navigate to the folder. And if I view as details, you can see that some are small thumbnail types, but others have got quite a lot of data. So they're full size JPEGs. And then if I go into the other folder, and you can see all the files here. I can't show you many of the pictures because these are a client work that I'm not allowed to share. But these Nikon RAW files of work I did way back, probably in 2018, that's telling me. So 1st of March 2018, where I was living, it was snowing. Let's open this one up. Now this image was taken on the 1st of March 2018, and this card has been used a lot since then. Okay, it's not the best picture in the world, but it does prove that you can find things on here that would otherwise have been lost to the world. But let's see what Recuva can do. Now the interface on this is a lot more user-friendly. It's more of a wizard that you can use to set it up. So you can select the type of files that you want, pictures, music, documents, video, that sort of thing, or all files. I'm going to choose all. Then you set which location you want to search. So we will go down and select the D folder, which is the Nikon folder. Again, go to next. Because I don't know what's on here, I'm going to select deep scan, hit start. And like before, it takes a while, so I'll speed this up again. So this interface is better and shows which files are in good condition and which aren't. And this one's found 841 files, but some of them, as you can see, are unknown. Some are unrecoverable and very poor condition, but there's a lot of excellent ones in there. Most of them are JPEGs. It looks like it's found the two video files, although one's very poor. The other one says it's in good condition. You can leave the incomplete files if you like, or try and recover them all. Let's do all and then hit recover. It does ask where it wants you to save it, so I'm going to go back into the recovered file. Click OK. And this process also takes a while, so again, I'll speed it up. So once that operation's complete, it'll show you that it recovered 841 files in total. Now it will tell you that you can upgrade to get advanced file recovery, automatic updates and all that sort of stuff, but you don't need to, so just click OK. And then if you go into the recovered folder and into recover, so you'll see there's the two video files. Now one of them was fully recovered, one of them wasn't. So interestingly, this found the video that Photorec didn't, but it doesn't seem, I think those files that were, yeah, couldn't recover the NEF RAW files. It can see them and they're there and they've got, most of them have got quite a lot of data, but it can't recover them for some reason. So as you can see, it's worth running both programs just to get the most out of the card. And one last thing, I found that if your photo editing software, Affinity in my case, or Photoshop, if that has trouble opening the file, then use something simpler. Preview on a Mac or Photos on Windows generally works, and then you can save it as a JPEG out of that. And that's it. You'll have saved a bunch of memories you've either forgotten about or thought were lost. So well done. Now, thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.